So my wife and I have some family friends, and they're a little older than us, and their kids are all in school, and we just really look up to them as parents and as husband and wife. And like, when I look at him, I kind of think, I want to be like he is, and my wife wants to be like she is, and we want to have a relationship like they do. And so we've kind of just admired watching them live, and we've kind of asked them to help mentor us through life. And so we've gotten a privilege to just kind of see how they live life. And about a year ago, David, he went to Sierra Leone on a mission trip, and when he came back, he was different. And you could tell he was different. Like, it wasn't one of those, I think there's something different. He lived a different life, and it was evident, and it was beautiful to see. And the crazy thing is it didn't end with him. Like, you watched him interact, and about a week went by, and you started noticing that his wife was different too. And she started kind of acting like he acted, and talking like he talked. And it didn't end with her. Later on, the kids started acting different. And so because of David's trip to Sierra Leone, a whole family kind of shifted and changed, and a paradigm shift occurred, and they lived a different kind of life. And one day we were kind of talking about kind of this new trajectory in life, and Tabby said, hey, you should come out and see what our kids are up to. And it turns out that their kids, along with some other kids whose parents had gone on the same trip, they'd built a lemonade stand. And what they said was, every single weekend and every single time that they were off school and they could do it, they were gonna go out to the golf course or go out to the street or go out to wherever they could and open up their lemonade stand and sell lemonade. I mean, something that most kids do. But the difference was that their lemonade stand wasn't gonna let them buy the new Nintendo or the new PSP or anything else like that. That their lemonade sales, they were gonna go send them back to Africa. And the crazy thing is that they're doing it. Like, they're actually saving lives by selling lemonade through a lemonade stand. And because they're doing it, the world is changing. And friends who are watching them are wanting to be a part of it because they're seeing that they can be a part of something that matters and something that's literally changing the world, that's incredibly simple to do. And they're doing it right there on their street. And best of all, it's fifth graders doing it and sixth graders doing it. Like I know for me, it's kind of my job to talk about changing the world and want to do those kind of things. But I don't know, when I saw what happened when a family actually stepped out and said, what if we decided everyone matters? And what if we decided that God loves everyone? And that requires my energy and my time and my life. What if I could change the world? And I'm starting to think they can, and I'm starting to think they are. It's a beautiful thing to see. I want to live a life like that, and I hope you do too. I want my kids to live a life like that. I want the story of God to be told in the simplest things, like lemonade stands.